Hello everyone, God Ablaze here, and welcome back to another episode of my Let's Play of The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. In the last episode, we started here at Forest Haven, went up over here to find that Great Fish Island had been destroyed, and the bearer of the third pearl that we were seeking had fled to Outside Island. So we then had to go up to Windfall Island here to get bombs, and then head all the way back to Outside Island here so that we could go and try to meet Jaboon, for he has sealed himself behind a giant stone slab. We also saw the pirates again, and did a lot of sailing and a lot of failing at a minigame. So yeah, it was a bit of a long episode, but it'll probably be a bit shorter once the editing is done. So anyways, we are back here at Outset Island. The Great Sea has been cursed, and time itself does not seem to want to move. This night seems to be without its end. But we can go and find out that choo-choos, vile choo-choos, have invaded our hometown. Yep. Not even Outset is safe anymore from these creatures. Anyways, if we wish to go and talk with the townsfolk, why don't we go and start with our own grandmother? No doubt she misses us. The music's so sad, too. Don't go. Don't leave. Don't leave your poor old grandma all alone. She's not doing so well now. She must have been worried sick from... She must have literally worried herself sick. Unfortunately, there's not anything we can do at this very moment, but there is something we can very soon do, and by that I mean it's literally on this island. We're going to go do it right now. Because trust me, it's worth it. It is so worth it. Anyways, if you want to, we can also go in here. And talk to Orca, since he sent us a letter. And he is punching a shark. Link, you are all right. Why did you not tell me about Aurel? That was thoughtless of you. This island has seen hard times ever since you departed. I do not know what you have been doing on your journey, but you seem a little more daring these days. That look in your eye is not the one you left here with. Very good. Show me just how much you've improved your sword skills. Sure thing. I must say, your skills with the sword are still at the level of a page. Very good, try to hit me 100 times or more before I hit you 3 times. Yeah, and as you can see, you only have 3 hearts here. Oh, whoops. I should have parried. I tried. I failed. I suck. Oh well. 26 blows, eh? Remember, though you may grow in strength, others grow stronger as well. You may come here to practice as often as you like. I will be happy to face off against you. That is a piece of heart that you can get there. If you manage to hit him 100 times without getting hit 3 times. If you want to go for that one, best of luck. You can get it right now. I am not going to go for that one. I'm just going to be honest. There is one or two pieces of art that are just beyond my capabilities of being able to obtain. So, like with the Minish Cap, I'm probably just going to have 19 hearts at the end here. But I will point out the pieces of art that I cannot get, like this one right here. Also, when you get 10 Night Quests, come back to it. For he will have something for you. But We only have two of them right now, and we haven't even met the monster that drops them, so it'll be a while before we get eight more. But anyways, what we need to do is we need to head across the island here. Anyways, trying to get up to the top of this island, where I feel that the freaking mini blend still here now. Time to just run. They spawn from off screen always. And also, we have a new character up here. Hello there. Ho, ho! So close. If only I could fly to the top of that hill. If only. Beneath that rock head. The I nearly spoke aloud without thinking. It's a secret, Heart. Yes, quite a secret. Second Heart. This here is Old Man Ho-Ho. He basically just has one giant bloodshot eye always staring through his telescope here, off into different places. He is currently staring at that giant rock with a face on it. But yeah, he shows up at other places around the Great Sea to go and point out different locations that are of interest. Anyways, as you can see here, bombs drop from the grass, which is always helpful, but I don't need bombs right now. What I need is some magic. So, game, if you would really like to go and give me some magic here. Game? Wait, seriously? Like, nothing? I appreciate the heart, but I need magic, game. I'm not going to be able to advance without magic. There we go! Finally! I mean, I prefer to have full magic, but I'll take it, I suppose. Because you see, the drawbridge, not the drawbridge, the suspension bridge that was damaged before, it's collapsed. So, we need to go and play the Wind's Requiem, set the wind in our favor. And use the Deku Leaf to get across to the forest now. Well, we failed at that, so instead what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down here. I'm doing so great at failing at things as of late. For what we can do is we can go in here. And have a bunch of pottery that we can just smash to pieces. And get magic back. Good. Tip of advice. A good tip of advice. If you want to make it across, start at a place higher than where you're going to land. That's typically how things work when you're gliding. There we go. And now we can go and enter into the forest here. It hasn't changed too much other than the fact that there are moblins patrolling around it now. And those ugly things. Okay, never mind. This place has changed some. I forgot those guys were here. I would gladly take the sword though. What you need to do is, you need to go here. Well, I suppose you don't really need to. In the GameCube version, you do need to go to this place. But in the Wii U version, not so much. What you need to do is just take out a bomb, throw it at this rock, jump away, and kaboom! We've blown up the rock here, unveiled a hole, and down we go. And into a fairy fountain. Now, my water expired on this pirate ship, so I'm just going to go and pour it out and finally have an empty bottle again. But we have a beautiful fairy fountain here. And we get to meet the Great Fairy, which actually looks very beautiful in this game compared to Ocarina of Time, or, I mean, really just Ocarina of Time. Young Waker of the Winds. Allow me to aid you in your quest. Suppose they're not as beautiful as the ones in the Minish Cap. But seriously, I do like the design on the Great Fairies in this game. But with this, we now have a larger wallet. We can now hold up to 1,000 rupees. This is always going to be 1,000 in the... Also, we get all our health and magic back. The fairies in this mansion show ease your weariness when you grow fatigued from your battles. Come here to be refreshed. And she disappears into many fairies. And if we go into here, we can go swipe our bottle and catch a fairy. She does not look happy to be in there, but we caught her. You caught a fairy in your bottle. When your life energy runs out and you collapse from exhaustion, this fairy will replenish your strength. But he would have liked to have one of those when we got when I got destroyed by those bombs. But yeah. These fairies will go and restore your health and magic. I can't remember how much magic they restore, but they give you 10 of your hearts back, if I recall correctly. So they're pretty good in this game. So yeah, man, the fairy fountains are so beautiful in this game. So, anyways, yeah, I'm not going to bother with them. There's no real point to it. You, however, since you're right here... you made these ugly things. Oh, hey, you... Oh, wait, I don't need magic. Never mind. Oh, jeez. Run away. Anyways, I will see you at Link's house. More mail! Here's the mail, it never fails. It makes me want to wag my tail. When it comes, I want to shout, mail! We have one letter delivered during this awful, endless midnight storm. I'm sorry to disturb you with this unsolicited letter. If the following does not interest you, please throw the letter away without a second thought. This is the kindest piece of junk mail I have ever received. But this is your big chance! Do you have a need of an empty bottle, a piece of heart, or a treasure chart? We have them at special bargain prices. But we only have one of each. Dun dun dun. If you're interested, go to the shop ship near Rock Spiral Island. First come, first serve. I can't wait to serve you. To those who took the time to read this letter, please accept my humble thanks. Assistant Manager, Rock Spiral Shopship. And we did a single green rupee. But we can hold 1,000 rupees now, so that's fine. But yes, anyways, the wallet upgrade I just got is not necessary in the Wii U version. However, if you wish to complete the game in the GameCube version, you need to upgrade your wallet there. It is mandatory. Anyways, let's head in here. For, while we can use fairies to go and heal Link when he dies in battle, we can also go and L-target Link's grandmother and use the fairy on her as well. And heal her of her illness. Oh, Link, is that you, Link? Grandma's always happy to see your bright, shining face. Link, my dear, sweet Link. You're safe. That's wonderful. Just wonderful. Did you do this? Did you heal me? Oh, you're such a sweet child. Oh, that's right. You and your sister are trying so hard to be strong. And I've just been sitting here, moaning and roaring. I'm your grandmother. I'm the one who should be taking care of you. I'm so sorry, Link. I haven't even considered what you must be going through. Grandma, it's okay. Especially given what you're about to give me. Link, this is all I have to give you right now. You can keep it in your empty bottle. And with this, we get the elixir soup. If there has ever been an item to be better than the fairy to put inside an empty bottle, this is it. This healthy soup your grandmother makes replenishes all of your life energy and all of your magic power. Doesn't matter how much you're missing, it all comes back. Also, your attack power is doubled until the first time you take damage. Now that is one hearty soup. And your kind old grandmother filled the bottle so full of those two helpings inside. Seriously. So let's go over that again. All health restored. All magic restored. Double damage until you take damage. And there are two helpings in the bottle. The only downside to this is that you can only have one bottle of it at a time. That is the only downside. But compared to everything else you have, it's amazing. Also, since you love the soup so much, if you ever run out, you can just come back to Grandma and she'll give you a new bottle of it for free. Like, seriously, this is like the best, one of the best items in that you could ever put in a bottle in any Zelda game. Grandma's going to try to be strong, so you try to be strong too. But don't do anything reckless. Oh, that's such a nice scene, though. So yes, we're going to go and very quickly go and put like anything else on the R button so we don't accidentally drink the soup. But yeah, so we have our elixir soup now here. We'll save that for an extreme emergency alongside our red potion. But with that done, it is now time to go see Jaboon. Really hoping that would give me some bombs. Yeah, Beetle is pulling in here. Let's see if he has some bombs. I'm gonna see if he has his bomb special or not. Especially after last episode. Yes, he does. The pirates sold me bombs for cheap. Okay. Why would? Are you acquainted with that adorable little pirate girl? Sort of. You have a bat. Thank you, Beetle. Anyways, 30 bombs for 60 rupees, buy them while you can. I will pass, since I will be literally buying one bomb for 60 rupees if that's the case. Yeah, something special you have there, Beetle. Anyways. Are you ready? If that is the case, then we must search for the cave around the backside of Outset, where Jaboon is said to hide. Now, if we go into the ship, if we go into the King of Alliance and push the left button on the D-pad in the Wii U version, we get a cannon here that we can fire the bombs out of. Though since it uses bombs out of ammunition, it can run out. Also, Wii U version is kind enough to go and show the trajectory of our firing path, so we get a good idea of where our bombs are going instead of just kind of blindly aiming, which is pretty nice to have. Though, yeah, unfortunately you don't have the D-pad thing in the Wind Waker on the GameCube, nor do you have the trajectory. So, yes. Anyways, well, we have this giant whirlpool on the back side of the island, and a giant stone slab as well. So what we need to do is we need to sail into the whirlpool and try to smack that stone slab with all bombs. And we also have a time limit, because if we reach the center of that whirlpool, we're done for. There we go. It's partially down. It's down a little bit more. Hopefully Jaboon's not freaking out too much. Hopefully he knows we're good people coming in here. And hey, it's done. That was simple enough. And the whirlpool's down. Hey, I did good at something. I didn't screw up something for once. Anyways, now into the cave we go. Giant Glowy! Well met indeed, Jaboon. I am pleased to see that you are safe. Yes, it seems Ganon has returned. There can be no other explanation. Unfortunately, that is not so. The one I have brought with me has no connection to the legendary one. And yet I sense great promise in the courage that this one possesses. I do. It is the only way. And with that conversation we could only understand half of, we get the third pearl. No dungeon required. And we get Nehru's pearl, so we got a pearl from the Guardians of the Skies, the Guardian of the Earth, and now the Guardian of the Water. A nice little trilogy there. Or trio, I mean. The Water Spirit Jaboon was kind enough to give you this jewel, a treasure of one of the goddesses. So, that foul rain and endless night were indeed elements of a curse brought on us by Ganon. You must intend to cast this land into pure darkness for all time. I believe I have. We're not sure what Jaboon was saying, and unfortunately we're never able to go and talk to him and interact with him again. But that was an interesting cutscene. Ganon's course has been broken by the power of the pearl that Jaboon gave us, so morning should come soon. It is well that we have gathered all the pearls. Are you ready, Link? I have marked the places where you must set the pearls on your sea charts. Once you place each of the pearls in its proper location, the proving grounds for your courage will become apparent. Clearly, the search for Jaboon has shown that Ganon has begun to make efforts to block our path forward. It is certain that the perils ahead will be greater than any you have faced thus far. You should finish any business you have on outset right now, so that you shall not have any regrets later. And with this, we can see on our map that we have three different spots that we need to go to. That happen to be those triangle islands that I mentioned about before. But yes, we have all three of the pearls now. We didn't even have to go through a dungeon to get that last one like we did the other two. Which is something I want to bring up. I mentioned last episode how I felt that perhaps... Which way is the wind blowing? Okay. I mentioned before that I felt that perhaps that Great Fish Isle was originally not supposed to be destroyed. And what I mean by that is because of the fact that we just got that pearl without having to go through a dungeon. And it just seems a bit odd that you just get that without having to go through a dungeon. There was no, like, water dungeon associated with the water pearl. Nothing like that. And so, what I think is, well, you see, the thing is, interviews have revealed that the Wind Waker was one of the few times in the Legend of Zelda franchise that the game had to come out by a specific point. They weren't allowed to really delay the Wind Waker any. Unlike pretty much all the other Zelda games, which got as many delays as they needed in order to go and make the game what it is. So they ended up having to cut 2 or 3 dungeons out of the Wind Waker here. And my theory is that Jabun's dungeon was one of those cut dungeons. Also, artwork from Hyrule Historia shows species, entire like species of characters that were cut out of the game. And my theory is that those species were going to be on Great Fish Island, but the island got destroyed, Jabun fled to Outset, and instead he just gives you the pearl straight up, instead of having you go and go through a dungeon instead. So yes, that's just my theory, that Great Fish Island was destroyed when they ended up having to go and cut the dungeon. And that is... Oh, shoot, no. That's a cyclone. I need to stay away from it for right now. The fish can... I can deal with the fish later. I can deal with getting those later. Because, for honestly, right now... This... Yeah, you just stay away from that cyclone until after the next dungeon, okay? Because that would just... That cyclone, that one we were told to take care of and deal with by his brother back in Dragon Roost... Yeah. We can't deal with him right now. If we hit him, he'll just throw us to a different random section of the Great Sea. So, anyways, as we head onward, I am just going to head on to this island here and probably just end the episode because, I mean, we had no time at Outset. We met Jabun. Morning has come as the curse in the Great Sea has been broken. And we have our objective now to go and take the 3 pearls and place them onto 3 different islands. Hoi, small fry! Yeah, I've heard. I take you want charts and information about this island? Then start by opening up your sea chart. And here we can see that we are at Southern Fairy Island, home of another great fairy. Listen up, Smallfire, this is just between you and me. On Outset Island, buried beneath the black soil, there's some serious treasure. I know it sounds like I'm trying to pull your leg, but I'm serious. Try digging there. What, you haven't got anything to dig with? I'd say try using an animal or something. Work smarter, not harder, Smallfire. And that's all the info I've got to offer. Oh, I missed a piece of heart on that island, didn't I? I totally did. Whoops. So yeah, if you take there's a pig that's grown giant on the island that I completely forgot to interact with. If you go there, you can go and get a piece of heart. I'm probably going to have to go back for it. Yeah. I'm just going to end this episode here. I guess I'll start the next episode off by getting said piece of art, and then I'll go and just continue on with the pearls here. Anyways, this fairy island, unfortunately, we can't do anything about it. Wait, can we? Okay, never mind, we can't. So fine, we'll end it with a great fairy, and then that'll be the end of the episode. For this great fairy will... Besides 40 healing us... Young Waker of the Winds, allow me to aid you in your quest. And now, as if 30 wasn't enough, we can now carry 60 bombs. The fairies in this fountain shall ease your weariness. When you grow fatigued from your battles, come here to be refreshed. And believe it or not, we can still upgrade our bomb bag again after that. Yeah, 60's not the max. We can hold an insane amount of bombs in this game. Kind of like in Minish Cap. But yeah, we have 60 bombs now, so woo! Anyways, that's it for this episode, everyone. I know, man, this is actually really long. I might have to go and split this episode up or something. Depends on how much gets edited out. But for now, this is Gordo Blaze, and I will see you all next time. So long, everyone.